Good evening. This is All India Radio and I am Sai Ramujtaba with the news at 9. The headlines. India condemns drone attacks on two oil facilities in Saudi Arabia. Supreme Court asked Center and Jammu and Kashmir administration to restore normalcy in valley, keeping national interest in mind. Government to give 8,500 crore rupees support to Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India to enhance loan availability to exporters. India and Slovenia signed 7 agreements and MOUs in science and technologies, sports and culture. And in football, Railways enter quarterfinals of 25th Senior Women's National Championship. India has condemned the drone attacks targeting two oil facilities in Saudi Arabia on Saturday. In a statement today, External Affairs Ministry spokesperson Ravish Kumar reiterated India's resolve to oppose terrorism in all its forms and manifestations. Meanwhile, the US has issued satellite images and cited intelligence to back its claim that Iran was behind the drone attacks on Abqaiq, the site of the largest oil processing plant run by the Saudi state oil company Aramco and the Khurais oil field. The attacks were claimed by Houthi rebels in Yemen. According to the BBC, unnamed US officials told American and international media that the direction and extent of the attacks cast doubt on Houthi involvement. Iran has denied involvement in the attacks. The attacks shutting 5% of global crude output caused the biggest surge in oil prices since 1991. The price rose 20% today but fell back later. A sudden surge in crude prices after drone attacks on Saudi Arabia's oil facilities hit global stocks today. Domestic indices also fell around 0.7%, a report.
Oil prices today surged nearly 20% at one point, with Brent crude posting its biggest intraday gain since the Gulf War in 1991 after an attack on Saudi Arabian oil facilities at the weekend. However, Brent lost early gains and was trading around 6% up in intraday trade. Following negative cues from global markets, Sensex at the Bombay Stock Exchange declined 262 points to close at 37,123. Nifty at the National Stock Exchange also fell 72 points to settle at 11,004. The rupee at the forex market also weakened 68 paise to 71 rupees and 60 against the US dollar. V. Ravi Kumar, AIR News.
The 16th round of Foreign Office consultations between India and Iran were held in Tehran today. An official release said during the consultations, the two sides reviewed the entire gamut of bilateral cooperation, ongoing connectivity and infrastructure development projects, including development of Shahid Baheshti Port, Chabahar, and full operationalization of the Chabahar Agreement between India, Iran and Afghanistan. It was agreed to maintain the momentum of mutually beneficial multifaceted bilateral cooperation and exchanges between the two sides. Foreign Secretary Vijay Gokhale led the Indian delegation. Deputy Foreign Minister Dr. Syed Abbas Araghchi led the Iranian side. The Foreign Secretary also called on Iran's Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Javad Zarif. U.S. President Donald Trump will join Prime Minister Narendra Modi at an Indian community program at Houston in Texas on 22nd of this month. Prime Minister Modi has welcomed President Trump's participation in the mega event. In a series of tweets, the Prime Minister said, "The special gesture of the U.S. President highlights the strength of India-U.S. bilateral relationship." He said it is also a recognition of the contribution of the Indian community to American society and economy. The Prime Minister said he looks forward to joining the Indian community in welcoming Mr. Trump at the program. The event, Howdy Modi, Shared Dreams, Bright Futures, is a community program hosted by Texas India Forum for Prime Minister Modi. Over 50,000 people are expected to attend the event. Governor Philip D. Murphy of New Jersey in the U.S. called on Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi today. Mr. Modi welcomed the governor's desire to promote closer commercial and people-to-people relations between New Jersey and India. An official release said the Prime Minister assured the visiting dignitary of India's support as New Jersey seeks to pursue meaningful cooperation with Indian states. President Ramnath Kovind and his Slovenian counterpart Borut Pahor have agreed to strengthen multilateralism and promote a multipolar world. Mr. Kovind today held bilateral meeting with President Pahor at Ljubljana, the capital city of Slovenia. In a statement issued after the meeting, President Kovind thanked Slovenian President for supporting India in its fight against cross-border terrorism. In a statement, Slovenian President expressed his commitment for greater ties with India. Our correspondent reports, India and Slovenia today signed 7 agreements and MOUs in diverse fields in the presence of President Ramnath Kovind and President Pahor.
The agreements were signed for greater cooperation in science and technology, sports, culture and mass media. The Bureau of Indian Standards and the Slovenian Institute of Standardization signed an agreement for a technical cooperation in the field of standardization. Apart from these, a memorandum of understanding was signed between Invest India and Spirit Slovenia to boost investment. IIT Kanpur signed an MOU with VGB Slovenia for Clean Ganga program. IIT Kanpur and Space SI also signed MOU for clean water technology to be adopted on River Ganga. In the evening today, President will address Slovenia-India Business Forum and an agreement will be signed between the Chamber of Commerce and Industry of Slovenia and Associated Chambers of Commerce and Industry of India, ASSOCHAM. Sudhindra, AIR News, Ljubljana.
This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts. The Supreme Court today asked the Centre and Jammu and Kashmir Administration to make all endeavours to restore normalcy in Kashmir Valley as soon as possible. However, the court made it clear that the restoration would be on a selective basis, keeping in mind national interest. A bench headed by Chief Justice of India, Ranjan Gogoi, and comprising Justices S.A. Bobade and S.A. Nazir, was told by Attorney General K.K. Venugopal about steps taken by authorities to restore normalcy in the state. The bench asked him to file an affidavit indicating steps taken so far in the matter. When the top court was told about the alleged shutdown of mobile and internet services in the valley, the bench said these issues could be dealt with by the Jammu and Kashmir High Court. Advocate Brinda Grover, appearing for petitioner and executive editor of Kashmir Times, Anuradha Bhaseen, told the bench that mobile, internet services and public transport are not working in the valley and it would be difficult for them to approach the High Court. Venugopal, however, said that issues raised by the petitioner do not appear to be genuine as Kashmir-based newspapers are being published and the government has been offering all kinds of assistance to them. The Supreme Court today also allowed senior Congress leader Ghulam Nabi Azad to visit Jammu and Kashmir but said he cannot hold any political rally. A bench headed by the Chief Justice said Mr. Azad can visit 4 districts, that is Srinagar, Jammu, Baramulla and Anantnag, to meet people. Jammu and Kashmir Administration today booked National Conference President Dr. Farooq Abdullah under Public Safety Act or PSA to maintain law and order. Dr. Abdullah is currently detained at his residence in Srinagar. Officials said the residence has been converted into and designated as a sub-jail with security arrangements by Special Services Group. Union Minister of State for Finance Anurag Thakur says Prime Minister Narendra Modi has given real freedom to people of Jammu and Kashmir from discrimination and underdevelopment. Addressing BJP leaders in Jammu today, he said abrogation of Articles 370 and 35A will bring prosperity and a new dawn of development in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal has said the central government will give a support of 8,500 crore rupees to Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India or ECGC in the next 5 years. Speaking to reporters in New Delhi today, Mr. Goyal said interest rates will now be just close to 3.5%. The minister said banks have been advised to extend this new facility to all exporters. Mr. Goyal also said ECGC has introduced a scheme called Niryat Rin Vikas Yojana or NIRVIK to enhance loan availability to exporters. The scheme will also help ease the lending process.
Credit availability बढ़ाने के लिए कुछ नए कदम लिए गए हैं और ECGC द्वारा नई स्कीम जिसका नाम NIRVIK 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 रखा गया है जिसका पूरा फॉर्म है निर्यात ऋण विकास योजना जिससे और सरल तरीके से और अधिक मात्रा में लोन अवेलेबल हो सके एक्सपोर्टर्स के लिए.
Electronics and Information Technology Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad has said India is a big market and companies investing in the country will get friendly policies and efficient human resource along with incentives from the government. He was addressing CEOs and heads of leading electronics and mobile companies in New Delhi today. Terming 5G as a new frontier for growth, he said the government is keen to see that India emerges as a big hub for 5G knowledge economy, patent creation and research and development activities. In Rajasthan, the Army and NDRF teams are carrying out relief and rescue work in flood-affected areas of the state. Our correspondent reports hundreds of people have been evacuated to safer places.
Due to large amount of water drainage from dams built on Chambal River, many areas of Kota, Sawai Madhopur and Dholpur district have been submerged. Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot took the aerial survey of the affected areas and said situation is under control. Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla also visited the flood affected areas of Kota and directed the administration to provide all possible relief to the people. Jitendra Divedi, EIR News, Jaipur.
In Madhya Pradesh as well, relief and rescue work is continuing on a war footing in flood-affected areas. Our correspondent reports that people are being evacuated to safer places in collaboration with army and other rescue teams.
Several rivers including Chambal, Narmada are flowing above the danger mark. At the same time, due to release of excess water from all the major dams including Gandhi Sagar, flood-like situation persists in many districts including Mandsaur, Neemaj, Bhind and Morena. The condition is also grim in entire Malwa Nimada region. While reviewing the situation, Chief Secretary S.R. Mohanty informed that the situation of flood is now under control.
Raisen, Sihor, Bhopal, Rajgarh, Shajapur, Agar Malwa, Ujjain, Indore, Jhabua, Ratlam, Mandsaur and Neemaj. In jilon mein jo samanya barish hoti hai usme se bahut adhik barish hua hai. Pure Madhya Pradesh mein kareeb 33% adhik barish ho chuki hai.
In Bhind and Morena, Army's Grenadiers and Engineering Corps have been deployed for the rescue and relief work. Sanjeev Sharma, AIR News, Bhopal.
Information and Broadcasting Minister Prakash Javadekar today said the new channel Doordarshan India will soon be available all over the world. Mr. Javadekar was speaking at a function marking the celebration of 60th Foundation Day of Doordarshan in New Delhi.
लोगों को अब सच्चे खबरें चाहिए. विश्वसनीय खबर देखनी है तो तुरंत लोग दूरदर्शन न्यूज लगाते हैं. अब एक डीडी इंडिया शुरू हो रहा है जो दुनिया भर में भारत की खबरें जैसे बीबीसी, सीएनएन, एनके वैसे ही आने वाले दिनों में डीडी न्यूज भी दुनिया में सब जगह देखने वाला एक बहुत रिलायबल चैनल होगा.
रेलवेज रीच द क्वार्टर फाइनल्स ऑफ द 25th सीनियर वुमेन्स नेशनल फुटबॉल चैंपियनशिप टुडे. They beat Andhra Pradesh in a group stage match 18-0. In another match, Haryana registered a comprehensive win over Bihar 7-1. Assam lost to Mizoram 0-2 and Madhya Pradesh defeated Karnataka 2-1. The News Services Division of All India Radio in its weekly bilingual live phone-in program Public Speak will bring you a discussion tonight on banning single use of plastic and waste management. This can be heard on FM Gold Channel and additional frequencies from 9:30 p.m. Listeners can ask questions to the experts sitting in our studio on toll-free telephone number 1-800-11-5767. You can also ask questions on telephone number 011-2331-4444. This program is also available on Doordarshan DTH. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. India condemns drone attacks on two oil facilities in Saudi Arabia. Supreme Court asked Center and Jammu and Kashmir administration to restore normalcy in valley, keeping national interest in mind. Government to give 8,500 crore rupees support to Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India to enhance loan availability to exporters. India and Slovenia signed 7 agreements and MOUs in science and technology, sports and culture. And in football, Railways enter quarterfinals of 25th Senior Women's National Championship. That's all in the news at 9. Good night.